As we reported earlier in the newscast, the new St. Louis County prosecuting attorney took office yesterday and began making some big changes today. Wesley Bell announced new prosecution policies and also terminated or began the termination process for three assistant prosecutors. One of the three, who wrote a disparaging remark on Facebook about his soon-to-be new boss, is one of those people. And he also terminated the prosecutor who presented the Michael Brown case to the grand jury, which failed to produce charges. I'm here with attorney Brad Young today to talk more about it. Always good to see you. Appreciate you being here.
Good to see you.
All right, first of all, let's start with the policy changes that caught our attention. So new policies in place here. First up, St. Louis County will no longer prosecute marijuana possession cases if the defendant has fewer than 100 grams. Explain that one to us. What does that mean?
Well, it means that if someone's arrested with a very small amount of marijuana, then they won't be charged with a crime. The problem with that is that it is a crime under state law. So the policy concern that one may have is you have a prosecuting attorney that says, I'm not going to enforce the law as written on the books. That's a concern.
And St. Louis City, Kimberly Gardner did the same thing, right? And then
correct.
The criticism there by a lot of attorneys was, wait a second, you can't make the law, you have to enforce the law. Is that the issue you see there?
That's correct. And when you have a situation where the prosecuting attorney is essentially saying, we're not going to prosecute for this crime, it changes whether that's really a crime practically, because people know they're not going to be arrested if they have small amounts of marijuana.
And we'll be honest, the next one here coming up, these are all things he said he was going to put in place if elected, and he's putting them in place. Next, they will no longer prosecute people who fail to pay child support. We've gotten a lot of emails from women's groups saying this is going to be a hardship on a lot of families. Explain your thoughts on this one.
Well, again, I'm really struggling to find out what's going to be the benefit of this, because when you have individuals who are not going to be prosecuted for this or not going to be imprisoned for failure to pay child support, what's the incentive to pay? And if these individuals do not pay their child support, women are going to be affected. Single parents are going to be affected. And most importantly, small children will be affected. And I don't really understand what's the benefit.
So I guess the argument is, though, if we put you in jail, you can't work, then you can't pay child support. Are there other options out there?
There are lots of options. For example, many states have imprisonment on the weekends so that people can still work during the week, and yet they're being punished for the crime. The other thing is short-term shock treatment prisons, where someone's in jail for a very short period of time, but it's very intense. Again, to set up the idea that this is wrong and we are going to punish that activity.
One last one here very quickly, and there were a bunch that were released today, but this final one, I guess, it doesn't need much explanation. Also, St. Louis County not requesting cash bail on misdemeanor cases. Why that one?
Well, the idea is that if they require a cash bail system, people that can't pay will be imprisoned under the theory that they'll be imprisoned for very small crimes. The problem, again, with that concept is, as the former prosecuting attorney Bob McCullough has said many occasions, these individuals were never placed in jail anyway for small misdemeanors or crimes. If they couldn't make the bail, they weren't placed in jail. So it's a change of policy, but it will have no practical effect because that wasn't being done under the prior administration.
Okay, let's talk about these terminations very quickly. First up, the prosecutor who presented evidence to the grand jury in the Michael Brown, Jason Stockley case. Now, Wesley also likely knows a lot of stuff we don't. He obviously knows a lot of stuff we don't. This one seemed pretty obvious as to why he would let her go. He didn't agree with the way she did it, right? Is that
right?
What we can read into this?
Exactly. And one could say, and again, I haven't seen the memos, I'm not involved with the case, but one could argue that there was a problem with presenting that information to the grand jury, and because of that, then termination is being sought.
And this last one here got a lot of attention on Facebook. Next to get the axe was Ed McSweeney. Been in the office for 34 years, but posted on Facebook right after the election that voters would regret what they did with this election, so he was fired. Now, if you and I, or if I did it, you have your own company, if I did it, I would be fired. What's the problem here? Why can't, or why is there an issue with his firing?
The Supreme Court's made a very clear distinction, John, between the termination of employees who work for private companies or those who work for public sector companies. Because the First Amendment, and by virtue of the 14th Amendment applicable to the state can't punish you for your speech. The Supreme Court has said on many occasions, as far back as 1968, that public sector employees do not forfeit their rights of freedom of speech merely because they're public sector employees. And that is what appears is what's happening here. When an individual makes a post on Facebook, he's going to be terminated for that. It looks as if he is being punished for the content of his speech, which is obviously prohibited under the Constitution.
So I'll leave this one up to you. I did get an email saying, if I say something bad about my company, mm-hmm. and we are a private company, can I get fired? Bottom line,
yes, you can.
I said,
yes,
you might not want to do that. I'm no attorney. I'm guessing you don't want to do that.
Yes, you can.
Brad, good to see you. Appreciate you being here.
My pleasure.
All right, we'll see you soon. Sandy.
Gentlemen.